algorithm is cured.
Clustering using representatives.
The next algorithm is cure. So it is called as clustering using representatives.
So this is again an agglomerative clustering algorithm, which is an improvisation of your Birch algorithm. So yesterday we have discussed your Birch algorithm. So Birch algorithm is balanced iterative reduced searching using clustering. And in that algorithm, it makes use of a tree data structure to cluster your objects. So where it consists of two important things. One is your branching factor to determine the number of branches, and second one is your threshold, which determines the number of objects that can be accommodated into your node. And with this, the tree construction starts, and it consists of two important phases. First phase is called as your clustering feature, cluster feature tree construction phase, or feature vector construction phase, which encodes the information of each object in form of three tuples, N, LS and SS, where N is the number of objects and the cluster, L is your linear sum of objects and SS is your squared sum of objects. So each and every iteration, once your clustering feature vector is constructed, for further iterations, your algorithm, it looks into the clustering feature vector rather than looking in the original database, and it automatically avoids or it reduces the time consumption, which is the limitation of your previous algorithm, and it makes suitable for working on very large data set. So in the second phase of the algorithm tried to allocate all the available objects into any of the clusters based on your threshold criteria. Here your threshold is nothing but it's a distance metric. It can be either a centroid metric or it can be any average metric, diameter, radius or any distance metric which puts your object into the cluster. So since we use a tree data structure, so tree data structure itself, it has a constraint that a node can accommodate only these many objects. So automatically it results in splitting of your nodes, and your algorithm iteratively split your nodes or merge your nodes and form a hierarchical structure to put in all your objects into the base. And your final phase is merging of your clusters, where we'll be ending up with your tree. And that algorithm, it was an improvisation over the previous algorithm in so many ways, and it gives us a better result and it gives us a good result. And again, the second algorithm what we are going to discuss in respect to hierarchical clustering algorithm is your cure algorithm, which is called as clustering using representative points, which is suitable for working on very large databases. Okay? So hierarchical clustering itself, it means that it has a tree-like data structure. The clusters are generated either in top-down fashion or in bottom-up. So either it is agglomerative clustering or it is a divisive clustering. So Birch is an agglomerative clustering. Again, this is going to be an agglomerative clustering approach. So already we are familiar with these two things. All these things we are already. So hierarchical clustering. So normally we have discussed about hierarchical clustering in two approaches. One is centroid based approaches, taking average as your mean metric or average as your point and grouping all your objects. And second one, it is all point strategy is another approach where every individual point is considered to see to that that object is going to be the best object to group all other points. These are the two things that it is being continuously used in all algorithm, right from k-mean algorithm to other algorithm. Or we have used minimum distance, maximum distance or average distance. These are the things that is being applied or operated in all the algorithm. And in Birch algorithm, again, what is the limitation of the hierarchical algorithm is, again, to put the objects into the node, we use either diameter or we use radius or we use your average. So average is again a centroid measure, diameter is again is going to be a centroid measure, radius is again is going to be a centroid measure, which is going to group all your objects. So that is the limitation of the approach, and all these algorithms, it suffers from the delimitation of something called as noise or outliers. So when we call it as noise or outliers, outliers are objects which do not fit into the normal grouping, or outliers are objects which lie far away from the existing cluster group. So when we use centroid as a metric or diameter as a metric, automatically pulling the object which is far away from a particular distance does not happen, and we leave so many points outside your cluster boundary. This is the limitation when we going for your real-time scenario. So here in this clustering algorithm cure, it uses a methodology in such a way that it does not avoid all objects as noise. It considers almost all the objects and form clusters, leaving very few pointers, outliers or noise point. This is the idea of this particular algorithm. So here, this algorithm cure, it forms your all point strategy approach. All point strategy is every point is considered as to form a cluster rather than taking as a center point, average as your centric measure. This is what it is, right? So when it is centroid based measure, you can see that it always group only objects which are nearer to the average, which is given in the right side of the diagram. Always average mean. Whereas when I take it as all point strategy, my cluster is not spherical in shape. The first cluster which is given in the top left, that right corner which is not spherical in shape, here my cluster is of irregular shape. So some point it can group all my point. And again here it is again an all point strategy. So this point it can group as many number of point. Whereas in this case it groups only objects which is spherical in shape. The cluster region itself which is spherical in shape or which is very circle in shape. This is the limitation of using average as your metric. So all point considering every point. So this pure algorithm, it uses all point strategy to form its clusters. Okay. So we're just going to leave this. So these are the demerits of your traditional clustering algorithm. Mainly favors spherical in shape. Data in the cluster must be very closely together, compact together, and each cluster must be separate far away, and each cluster will be at so many places because everywhere you have only average measure and this average can form only fewer grouping. So one cluster will be this end, the other cluster will be the other end, and the other cluster will be other end. Linking all these clusters again it becomes a problematic. Either you have to go a minimum distance or maximum distance or an average distance. This is the delimitation when we go centroid as my metric. So to overcome that, this algorithm, so these are all the things. So what is the cure approach here it is. So this algorithm, it uses clustering using representative point. From the name itself, it is clear that it is going to consider all point strategy. So among all the objects that has to be grouped, it is going to choose some point as its representative point. So choosing representative point is going to be my random selection. It's going to be my random selection. So when I have 100 points or 100 objects which has to be grouped, so in this case of clustering cure algorithm, what it does is it chooses some points here and there at its representative points initially, and those points are chosen in random fashion because initially we cannot do anything. In order to start with it, I choose some points here and there located and I pick the point as a random strategy. Now what we do is, with respect to that point as my representative point, I try to group all my objects whichever it is closer to them. So here what this algorithm it does is, it maintains a distance threshold. So from a point, representative point, to a larger distance, it maintains an area boundary called as a threshold in such a way that it can pull all the objects which is behind the threshold. So this representative point will be moving towards the boundary and form the cluster groups. This is how this algorithm it gets iterated. You clear or not? So here what is not is being used? Average is not used. When I take average, I can form only clusters which is round in shape, circle in shape or spherical in shape. So what here this algorithm it does is, instead of choosing some point, I choose some point as my representative points here and there randomly. Now second condition is, I choose a boundary location, say a threshold value which is my distance. So from the representative point, algorithm move towards to the boundary, grouping all the objects. So no point will be left as an outlier, or very few point will be left as an outlier which does not fit into the threshold value. So this algorithm, it reduces to a distance or it moves to the particular point unless it groups all your objects. This is the idea of this algorithm. You clear or not? What is the idea of this algorithm? So you should be clear about what is the limitation of all the algorithm. So all the algorithm, we use distance as my metric. So whenever I use distance as my metric, whenever I go average, centric, radius, diameter or whatever it is, my cluster is going to be spherical in shape. I cannot group anything which is centroid or average in group. So it will not be appropriate or it will not be correct. So to other alternate approaches, considering all the points. So when I consider all the points, my time complex necessary, it automatically increases. When I have 1000 object, then I have to examine all 1000 object to see to that it forms a good cluster. So we use a random sampling technique. So in random sampling technique, what I do is, instead of examining all 1000 object, I examine 100 objects and I pick up 100 samples and try to form the cluster. Again, it has its own limitation. So all the algorithms, we try to improvise in one way or other to improve the efficiency of clusters in grouping more number of objects. Clear or not? And take them. So this is what it is called as your all point strategy. So cluster or merge until they get at least C points. So number of points also should be there. Two conditions. First one is choosing your representative point. Second one is grouping the representative point based on a specific threshold. And each cluster we determine it should group 100 objects. So then it searches all 100 objects within that specific boundary location. So it forms good clusters. Which is not the criteria for average approaches. Okay? So this is your advantage of your QR algorithm with respect to the other algorithms, right? So this is your started point. So you can have points here and there. So I can choose red as my scattered point. If I choose red as my scattered point, or a blue is my scattered point somewhere. So blue it or left down second figure. I'm trying to explain left down second figure. First one it is an average metric. I form a representative point, say center point, and it has formed the cluster here at this point of time. Here it has formed a cluster. So here what I do is, I choose this is my representative point for my second iteration, and this point it moves towards this area. It moves towards forming more objects and it forms clusters. So it will be pulling all the objects to this cluster. See, now this red, it will be moving towards. Every time your distance space will be increasing and it forms clusters, and you will get clusters with irregular shape. 1, 2, 3, 4. This is how you are supposed to listen your figure. Top, down, left, right. Sorry, right, up. This is how you are supposed to, in the square or you can view the figure. The first one it is spherical in shape. Second one, vandu choosing my blue point, right? And pulling all the point which is outside, my red is which is outside. So I'll be pulling into this. And again, I'm trying to pull another object as my representative point and may pull my object. So always I'll pull all my objects. So here my clusters will be of irregular in shape. In a point, average na matunna anywhere go. Metric, center point. So when it's not average, my point can be anywhere. So this is how we can group over any of your objects. Any real-time application when I want to group object, this is my main strategy. You can consider any real-time objects, right? If you want to group patients with respect to who are affected with dengue, when you want to do that, then I cannot take an average metric. Whatever centra vechta, I cannot say that this persons are affected with dengue. I have to move across the entire solution space and say that among the entire region of Vadavelli, these people are affected with dengue. This is how my diagnosis should end it. So there I have to examine each and every person, each and every individual, and how do I move, that it becomes very important. So whether I move from Vadavelli to Bhartiyar University, or from Vadavelli I form a boundary and start moving, from Bhartiyar University I'll take a boundary and start moving and form clustering with irregular shape. So this is how you can use your QR algorithm. Or it can be applied for any application, but the strategy of application is different. The idea of getting applied algorithm is different. Right? So what is its limitation? It is not sensitive to noise. This is your advantage. Noise it is an outlier which does not fit into the normal grouping. So it is not sensitive to outliers. It is capable of grouping objects which is even nearer to the boundary location, which was good in DBSCAN algorithm, which was worst in all the algorithm. This is the comparative analytics with respect to this algorithm. So this is your QR algorithm. So what are the other alternatings? What you can do with is, that is random sampling you can do it. So choosing representative point, instead of choosing one single point, I can have some 10 points and try to form clusters with 10 representative points and choose the best point. This is one thing. And second one, what it is, partitioning. I can partition the data set into so many points, apply the same principle so that I get better clustering algorithm. And third one, it is labeling data, and this, that is using weights, neural networks concept that we leave out. So handling outliers. Since outlier it is something the A and the group, so since I use random sampling, I don't have anything called as outlier. Automatically outlier will not be avoided, because random sampling nala enadhe larger group. So edume fit na avama povadhe, everything will be coming into my group. So that is one advantage. Right? So these are the other enhancement. Enhancement na improvisation that can be dealt with the respect to this cure algorithm. So ipa in the algorithm they propose working on single data set. So now I can partition into n data set, apply the sum and merge all the clusters. This gives me the better improvisation. So where it can be worked on larger database. And this is what we call it as pseudocode. அதாவது அல்கரிதமுக்கு அடுத்த டேம் பிஃபோர் கன்ஸ்ட்ரக்டிங் இன்டு ப்ரோக்ராமிங் ப்ரோக்ராமிங் லாங்குவேஜ்க்கு மாடிஃபை பண்ணுறதுக்கு முன்னாடி நார்மலி வி டூ ரைட் சூடோகோட். சூடோகோட் இஸ் அ ஜெனரிக் ரெப்ரஸன்டேஷன் விச் கேன் பி கன்வெர்டட் இன்டு எனி ப்ரோக்ராமிங் லாங்குவேஜ் கன்ஸ்ட்ரக்ட். ஸோ சூடோகோடுக்கு வந்து யூ டோன்ட் ஹேவ் எனி ப்ரோக்ராமிங் லாங்குவேஜ் சின்டெக்ஸ். ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் யுவர் சூடோகோட். ஸோ எல்லாமே இருக்கும், மீன் இஃப் எல்லாமே இருக்கும், பட் இட் வில் பி அ சூடோகோட் ஃபார் யுவர் க்யூர். ஸோ யூ ஷுட் நோ ஹவு டு ரைட் அ சூடோகோட். எப்படி ப்ரோக்ராமிங் கன்ஸ்ட்ரக்டாக மாற்றணும். ஸோ ஒன்ஸ் ஐ ஹேவ் அன் அல்காரிதம் ஐ ஷுட் கம் அவுட் வித் மை ஐடியா. ஒன்ஸ் ஐ கம் அவுட் வித் மை ஐடியா தென் ஐ ஷுட் கன்சிடர் மை டேட்டா செட். ஸோ அந்த டேட்டா செட் ஆட்ரிபியூட்ஸ் ஆர் ஹவ் யூர் கோயிங் டு மாடல் இன் டு யுவர் அல்காரிதம். Once you do that, what data structures you are going to use, that has to be decided. Whether it's going to be an array or enga iterate pannanum, enga for loop podanum, enga while loop podanum, eppadi and the process iterate panni you are going to get the result. This step it has to be very clear in order to convert into your output, right? So which is very very important. So the worst case time complexity is order of n square log n, and the best case time complexity is O of n, which is a linear sum. பாரத் ரத்னா டாக்டர் ஏபிஜே அப்துல் கலாம் ஆன் 15/10/2015 as youth awakening day. With respect to that the university, as per the guidelines of higher education secretary, with respect to this Abdul Kalam's birthday, essay competition, right, and elocution competition will be conducted today 13/10 at 1 to 4:30 p.m. at Nachimuthu seminar hall, Bharatiya University. So the students, two NSS volunteers from your department for each competition in the above. So two volunteers or anybody who are interested, you can go and participate into that. So there you will be finalized. And idu vandha enga nadakkum appdin sonna 15th anniki Chennai it will be conducted again, once again, for all the four districts. Chennai, Coimbatore, Erode, Nilgiri. So the naal district ko same ringa win pannaravanga எல்லாருமே இப்படி கம்ப்ளீட்டிங் ஆன் 15 பேர் அண்ட் வி வில் பி அவார்டட் வித் பிரைஸஸ். ஸோ யுவர் டைட்டில் டாபிக் அதெல்லாமே ஒன்றுமே சொல்ல, எஸ்ஏ காம்படிஷன் வித் ரெஸ்பெக்ட் டு ஹிஸ் ட்ரீம் டு அதுவாக தான் இருக்கும்னு நினைக்கிறேன், ரைட்? ஸோ யுவர் இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் கேன் சி எஸ்ஏ காம்படிஷன் டைட்டில் வந்து இந்திய விண்வெளி பயணம், இந்தியன் ஸ்பேஸ் ஜேர்னி அண்ட் அன்றாட வாழ்வில் அறிவியல் மற்றும் தொழில்நுட்பத்தின் பயன்பாடு, யூஸ் ஆஃப் சயின்ஸ் அண்ட் டெக்னாலஜி இன் டெய்லி லைஃப். நெக்ஸ்ட் டாபிக் வந்து மனித நலனில் அறிவியல், சயின்ஸ் ஃபார் ஹியூமன் வெல்ஃபேர். அடுத்தது மாணவர் ஊக்குவிப்பில் பாரத் ரத்னா டாக்டர் ஏஜிபி அப்துல் கலாமின் பங்கு, ரோல் ஆஃப் டாக்டர் ஏஜிபி அப்துல் கலாம் இன் மோட்டிவேட்டிங் ஸ்டூடெண்ட்ஸ் ஓவர் சயின்டிஃபிக் டெம்பர், தென் சயின்ஸ் அண்ட் என்விரான்மெண்ட். அடுத்தது வந்து சயின்ஸ் ஃபார் பெட்டர் ஹெல்த் அண்ட் பேச்சு போட்டி. அதில் என்னென்னா அறிவியல் முன்னேற்றத்தில் பாரத் ரத்னா டாக்டர் ஏஜிபி அப்துல் கலாம். செகண்ட் ஒன் வந்து அறிவியல் சிந்தனை உருவாகத்தில் இளைஞர்களின் பங்கு, ரோல் ஆஃப் யூத் இன் பில்டிங் சயின்டிஃபிக் டெம்பர், ஏவுகணை நாயகன் பாரத் ரத்னா டாக்டர் ஏபிஜே அப்துல் கலாம். திஸ் இஸ் கைன் ஆஃப் டாபிக். இந்தியாவை வல்லரசு ஆக்குவதில் அறிவியல், சயின்ஸ் ஃபார் மேக்கிங் இந்தியா எ சூப்பர் பவர், திஸ் இஸ் எ டாபிக். என்விஷன் அண்ட் இன்வகேஷன், புதியன படைத்தலின் கனவு, திஸ் இஸ் கைன் ஆஃப் டாபிக். அறிவியல் வளர்ச்சியில் இந்தியர்கள், கான்ட்ரிபியூஷன் டு சயின்ஸ் பை இந்தியன்ஸ். இதெல்லாம் வந்து பேச்சு போட்டி. முன்னாடி கொடுத்துருந்த 5 டாபிக் வந்து கட்டுரை போட்டி. ஸோ ஹூவர் இஸ் இன்ட்ரெஸ்டட், ஐ திங்க் யூ கேன் ரைட் போத் இன் எனி லாங்குவேஜ். லாங்குவேஜ் இஸ் நாட் தி பேரியர் டு பார்ட்டிசிபேட். யூ கேன் டாக் போத் இன் இங்கிலீஷ் ஆர் இன் ஆஸ் வெல் இஸ் இன் தமிழ். அதனால் இஃப் யூர் இன்ட்ரெஸ்டட் யூ கேன் கோ பார்ட்டிசிபேட். ஸோ யூ வில் பி கிவன் ஆன் டியூட்டி டு பார்ட்டிசிபேட். யார் போகிறீங்களோ இந்த கன்சர்ன் ஸ்டாஃப் கிட்ட சொல்லிட்டு யூ கேன் ஜஸ்ட் கோ பார்ட்டிசிபேட் இஃப் எனிபடி யூர் இன்ட்ரெஸ்டட் வித் ரெஸ்பெக்ட் டு தீஸ் டாபிக். So this is the time complexity, worst complexity, best complexity and better complexity, best case. Worst case is order of n square, polynomial increase, exponential increase. Data set vara time increase aayite irukudhu, polynomial increase. In order, space complexity is order of n, it is linear. So it is not due to tree structure. If you use tree structure, your time complexity, space complexity will be linear. Why tree structure always your space complexity is linear? Because you're searching always you divide based on conditions. Either this side or that side or that side. Narendra, I think you can wake up. And conclusions, Q can identify clusters that are not spherical but are ellipsoid. Q is robust to outliers, clusters correctly, clusters data with large differences in cluster size. And you can use partitioning and sampling technique to enhance your algorithm. And running time, it is very, very minimum compared to other algorithmic approaches. These are the advantages of your algorithm with respect to other clustering algorithms. Right? So you can take down. I'll just give you 2 minutes time and we'll move on to the next algorithm, Cactus, Student Rock.